I think that I would like to ask to Professor Michael Hammond to come, because he has to speak about the second important topic on trifocal technology, because the Sulcoflex naturally is something that is unique, is the first time. So is I think that we need to take the attention of the audience on that topic. So please.
Thank you very much. Thank you for the invitation. And I want to welcome you in Vienna, my home city. I hope you enjoy the stay here and the Congress. Yes. I had the opportunity to implant the first trifocal add-on lens in the world, and I want to present you my first data. And I want to present you the history of this development and all the steps we had to go through. The initial trial, I implanted now 20 eyes with this lens. It is a trifocal duet procedure where I do the cataract, then I implant a bag lens with monofocal optics, and on top I put the trifocal multifocal lens. I also did an enhancement operation. It's only one patient I have till now, so I implanted the second lens on top of an old in the bag lens. I will show you in a few minutes. The world's first implantation was on the 13th of July, and I will go through these steps now quite in a short time period, I hope. So, we did quite a huge amount of research testing the materials. So we found in the 90s that hydrophilic material is very highly UV biocompatible. And that's important for lenses in the sulcus. The reputation of lenses in the sulcus is not the best, because you have a complication and then you implant in the sulcus. You are not used to use a lens primarily elective for putting it into the sulcus. But with that kind of material and the special design, it works very nicely. So we could show that UVL biocompatibility is high in hydrophilic material. Not so in the bag sometimes, but this has changed with the design too. But especially in the UVL tissue area, in the sulcus, it works very nicely. And that's more important in eyes with PECs or eyes with uveitis, because there you have more inflammation. So right now there are 3 add-on lenses on the market. They are all hydrophilic. This has some background. There was once a silicone lens too, but this has waned. It's gone. So these are the old models, aspheric monofocal, refractive bifocal, and toric, and the combination of toric and refractive multifocal. We did a publication in 2009, so now we have over 10 years of experience with this kind of lens. And in that study, to conclude, we didn't find any big or severe complication. There was a nice distance between the iris and the lens surface, and between the first, the bag lens, and the lens. There was no distortion of the optics, and so the lenses worked very nicely. There also was a cadaver eye study performed by Liliana Werner, and she could show with the Miyake technique that the position of the lens is very nicely in the sulcus, and it's not irritating some tissue to some extent. And more important, in my opinion, is the data from the optical bench. Because one could think that if you have 4 surfaces within one eye, that makes more glare or more optical problems. But in principle, Dr. Schrecker found, and he published that in the Journal of Cataract and Refractive Surgery, that there are almost the same reflections and there is no more light loss, so the optical quality is about the same if you have 2 lenses within the eye in that certain position. We did a centration study, and that was interesting too. We had in the same eye as we had 2 lenses, and we tested if the centration of the bag lens is comparable, better or less, than the centration of the sulcus lens. And there we found some slight significant difference. We found that the centration was better in the sulcus. And even more important, it was stable, because the sulcus usually is not changing. The bag has contraction forces, there are changes, especially in the first year. So there is a fixed position of that lens, and in general, the centration was better than in the back of the back lenses. So in conclusion, after 10 years of an overview, we could say that supplementary IOLs are effective for secondary enhancement, so if you have a biometrical surprise, for instance, of the surgical result, and for a primary duet implantation. They represent a reversible and exchangeable technology for the future. So what was the next step now? The next step was to create a new optic, a modern, more modern trifocal optic, a diffractive trifocal optic. And you see here, the optic of the Sulcoflex lens, in principle, is the same as the Ray 1 trifocal lens. I don't go through the details, you have heard that already, but it's the same optical technology. So it also has 16 rings and so on and so on. Here we have the other competitors, and on the left side you see the trifocal Sulcoflex lens. So we performed a comparative study trying to find differences between the Zeiss lens and the Symphony lens and the Ray 1 trifocal lens, and in general we didn't find significant differences with the Zeiss lens and the Ray 1 trifocal, and we had very promising nice curves with the bag lens. So now I will show you the first, that is really the first surgery of a Sulcoflex trifocal lens. I usually perform a temporal incision, 2.4 millimeters, then the cataract, then you implant the bag lens. You can choose any material, any lens. You don't need to have a Rayner lens, but you may use a Rayner lens, but you can have a silicone lens or a hydrophobic acrylic lens. Then it is important that you remove the visco material from the bag. I usually go behind the lens and remove it. Then I instill viscoelastic behind the iris, that I have a sulcus prepared, nice space to implant the lens. And here you see this very thin and soft hydrophilic lens with the rings. It's concave on the posterior surface so that you don't have a contact between the two lenses. And you still have to implant it not with a preloaded system, but it's a very nice shooter. It's very new now, because in former times there was a little bit more tricky implantation technique to be used. But right now with this Medicell injector, it works very nicely. And you will see the lens unfolds very gentle and very controlled. Even though in that case, this is the first case, the optic came over the leading haptic, but that's not a problem with that lens because it's so soft, you easily may manipulate that lens, and you will see in a few seconds that you can easily bring that haptic into the sulcus where it should be positioned. So here you see these rings and the lens on top of the primary implant. Now you see. And it's important that you remove the viscoelastic from the interface. So usually I go into the interface with a spatula, lifting the lens and removing the viscoelastic from there, and then from the anterior chamber and from behind the iris. Here that's a case of, this my other case with this enhancement. So I put the lens on top of an old bag lens. You will see and I did it on axis incision because of slight small astigmatism. Here you see the lens again. It's important that you bring the lens more to the front, not here to the back, as I show you here, because then you may entrap the haptic. So as soon as you have it in front, it's no problem, and you will never have any problems implanting that lens controlled and without any problem. Here you see the posterior, some instant posterior opacification, but in the center was clear, so I didn't use a YAG capsulotomy. You could do it before, but usually it's better to do it later if you like, because then you are more safe. Here again, the implantation, and here you see how I bring the haptics behind the iris. So preliminary results with the duet implantation, 20 eyes of 10 patients. I did it bilaterally on the same occasion. The defocus curve, very nice visual acuity on very nice distance interval from 0 to minus 3 with very good levels. Here you have the contrast sensitivity in the mesopic and in the photopic area. And here you see the curves. the comparison between the defocus curve of the Sulcoflex trifocal and the Ray-1 trifocal, the bag lens. And these are very preliminary data because I just had 7 weeks to do these cases and to collect the data. It will take time, but my general feeling is that it works as good, as the optic is the same, it was to expect, as the Ray-1 trifocal. Here, the secondary enhancement, this was a female patient, which was very happy afterwards, and I mentioned here there was the secondary cataract. Because of that, the vision was not as good as on the left eye, which was 100% on the left eye, as to expect. Here you have the post-op picture. You see the fibrosis of the anterior capsule and the posterior Eschnig pearls. So in conclusion, there was an excellent visual acuity across all distances. All patients were satisfied with the distance, intermediate, and near vision. There was no surgical or post-op complication, and the results are comparable to the trifocal in the bag IOL size Ray-1. But, and that's the important thing in my opinion, it's reversible. Supplementary IOLs offer an adaptive option. So you may plant that lens at any time if the patient doesn't like it because of problems with neuroadaptation, which should not happen. You have to take time to check that. But if it happens, you may tell the patient, I can bring that lens out at any time. But more important, if you do young patients with 30 or 40 years, or 50, still is young, I think, then you never know what happens in 20 years or whatsoever. If they create an AMD, a diabetes, a glaucoma, and whatsoever. And at that later time, where you never know, you have the option to take that lens out and to bring more contrast into that diseased eye. So I think it's a reversible option, and for that reason, I'm very convinced that that system should help to treat our patients in the future. So the main indications today in phakic patients, multifocal duet procedure, single step, both lenses into the eye, and in pseudophakic patients, multifocal enhancement for our patients who are already pseudophakic, or in case of a biometrical surprise, you may add this lens in order to make him happy again. So I want to thank you very much, and my team, for the help in that study. Thank you very much.
Thank you.